get familiar with impressions. Oh my gosh. No.
Spending time with my wife. As you can see, our desks are set up spaced apart, facing forward. This will help with social defense.
Okay. Okay. There's no point in it if I don't know. Okay, should be coming any moment. They should be coming any moment. Okay.
The voice could not be used in its glory.
smell of water. Sarah Brightman. Okay, so, you know, and that reminds me, actually, of another song that I actually came up with. It's called, it's from My Fair Lady. It's sung by, Audrey Hepburn, and I think that that goes along with that, So I just want to, first of all, before I do that, before I play that song to you, just so that you can hear kind of the similarity of their two voices. So, today, what I want to do is I want to introduce you all to my special ed teacher, Justin Tyson, Mr. Tyson. He will be here as a guest, not an admitted guest, but just as someone who I call a kind of a nindic, which means somebody who is coming here for the purpose of not being part of the invention, for the purpose of not visiting the invention, but for the purpose of visiting me for another reason. Specifically, having to do with the fact that the guests that are the hardest people to bring in for me are the ones in my real life, because I'm doing all of this, and yet I have another relationship with them in real life. But, you know, I just want to have guilt-free cards today. Now, I'm not going to feel bad about it. It's something very, very exciting. And something very special. And very, very important to me that also, you know, we can find people who play in movies and TV shows and things, but, and there's a lot of technical difficulties with getting them here, but personally, deep and kind of soulfully, more from the heart, it's harder to bring those types of people in here. And I think that it's so wonderful that it worked out that both Zach Callison and Mr. Tyson are here together. They're here together. Now, realize that If I was dealing with somebody born, I don't know, in, I don't know, late October, per se, I don't think that I would say Mr. Tyson. I would say the first name. So, it really, really does make a difference. And I know that you recently had that altered around. And I'm very, very glad, because that's going to open up a lot of doorways of compassion, as you know. It really is. It really will make a difference to me for you specifically. So, do you know who this is from other besides right here, right now? Yeah. So, I think what would be a good idea, and you know, you're going to get to know him a little bit better as the day goes, but he basically is an actor who played in several movies, most famous, in my mind, in my heart, for being in Just That Magic. And playing a character named Chuck Pizer, Charles Pizer, which is one of the important unresemblances of Mr. Tyson. A resemblance, but the resemblance isn't there, but at the same time, there's something there that, despite the differences, there may be a little resemblance. So that's what a resemblance is. And, you know, for the people that come here, they don't know, like a lot of the time, they don't know what I'm talking about. And they're confused. And they don't know what I'm getting at in terms of all of the terminology and all of the things. But I'm sure that you'll catch on. So I'll talk about things that you might not understand, kind of bridge and connect things together that you might not get. Let me see here. So, what I wanted to do is, I just want to tell you, I hope that I'm not losing my train of schedule that I planned out. First of all, I want to tell you that after this is done, after the big surprise at the end of this, we are going to be going over to the Edmonton headquarters. And we are going to be, I'm going to be talking about my relationship. You know, with you, but it's not going to be together. We're not going to be together in the same room. We'll be kind of broken apart. So I will be going in, and you know, you'll be going in, and the film will be edited, and there'll be a preview with which, you know, I'm talking, you're talking, kind of back and forth to kind of preview it. And so I just want to play for you the first kind of transition into me speaking. And I'm going to hit to the bottom note. And I'm going to tell the relationship from my perspective. And then you're going to tell from your perspective. It should be very interesting. And then they will come together. And there might be a couple times where, you know, I might say something, you might say something different. That might be kind of an argument in disguise. I don't know. But, let's see here. So, the first transition is, and I just want to find that thing. And I just want to do this really, really quickly so that I can get into everything else. Okay, I'm gonna get this up. So this is basically what it's gonna be. And this, and I'm gonna kind of break out the words that you don't know, is, will be expressing the person. I want to talk about the difference between those two things. Remember that expressing is expressing with somebody, expressing, you know, to that person, with that person, in support of that person. Expressing is the opposite. It is expressing something against that person, what you want to see yourself as being into or playing, maybe for the purpose of teaching them a lesson or offering them this perspective that you think that they need, and giving it away to them and showing this off to them. That's something that's very, very different that you feel would be the best complement to that, kind of like in astrology, you know, Aries and Libra. So that's essentially what that means, is expressing and expressing. Yeah, I know. It is kind of a lot. So here it is. Okay, and that's it, you know, that song from The Sound of Music. For those of you that are not familiar with The Sound of Music, okay, and I need to turn that off completely. Okay, and then I'm going to turn this off now, the next thing that I'm going to do, I'm going to play two more things before I get into it. The first of which is going to be that song that sounds like Sarah Brightman. Because I just want to use that as kind of an expressor, but an expressor at the same time. So, let me see. So, here it is. Oh, good grief.
Play Unlimited, our most
okay, that's an ad.